Sexism in gaming is a hot potato issue right now. We've had talk of Penny Arcade making jokes about dickwads, David Jaffe comparing technology to vaginas, and we've also had Duke Nukem Forever's Capture the Babe, a game mode in which you punch women in the face with a boxing glove strapped to the end of your cock. Well, that's only if you believe Fox News. You actually give her a smack on the arse now and then. However, that is still a rather sensitive subject with many women. But I'm sure that Duke Nukem Forever is the kind of robust intellectual forum in which to explore these problems.
What am I, a chimpanzee?
In many cases, I think the issue of sexism is overblown, and it's very easy to get caught up in our inability to differentiate jokes from actual instances of hatred. In fact, I don't think we as a community even deserve to have these discussions if we're still going to get up in arms over a simple little joke and rob games comments and any kind of humour of its context just to focus on the bit that we find particularly offensive. That said, there is a serious issue to be had, and that's to be found in the disproportionate sexualization of women in games. However, that's not a problem I think necessarily has to, shall we say, go away. You see, here's a simple truth. Men like to look at tits. I'm sorry if a few people find that offensive, but that's simply the way we're wired. I didn't come up with the concept. It's a little thing we call fucking genetics, and it's the reason why the human species is here. Men like to, I guess, objectify women because that's what they've evolved to do.
Oh yeah, I'm bringing sexy back.
Now the problem I have is with balance. You see, we've got women parading around game worlds in nothing but a chainmail bikini to protect their flesh, and it looks rather stupid when you put them next to a man in full plate armour. So the simple answer is just to put women in full plate armour, yes? No! The answer to address this balance is to put men in chainmail bikinis as well, because that's the issue, ladies and gentlemen. Not too many half-naked women in games, not enough half-naked dudes! That's right, folks. Quasi-nudity for all, not just the females. Because at the end of the day, who doesn't want to look at Marcus Fenix in a tight leather thong?
Who wants toast?
And as for Duke Nukem Forever, keep Capture the Babe, but add in a new mode for the ladies. Diddle the Duke. A game in which you fiddle with Duke Nukem's balls while he cries and begs you to stop.
No, come on, no.
Sex sells, ladies and gentlemen, but that doesn't mean we have to sell it exclusively to males. Sex can sell to women as well. Don't believe me? Take a trip to DeviantArt and put Devil May Cry in the search bar. That'll give you all the proof you need. Women are interested in sex just as much as men. And my proposal eliminates sexism by objectifying everyone and selling games to everybody. An option for quasi-nudity for men and women, and an option for full-plate armour for men and women if you're feeling prudish. We have to cater in these modern times to vaginas just as much as penises. And if that's not equality, I don't know what is.